Hi guys, in this video we're gonna show how to do some sort of basic operation using PyPDF2. Using PyPDF2 with the Jupyter Notebook, you can do some sort of some operation into your PDF file. So if you have to do you have to bring or install the PDF file, PyPDF2 file package in your environment. So if you don't have them, you have to install them in your machine. So like in the first line, I have shown that I write down the pip install PyPDF2. Since it was already installed in my machine, it said that a requirement is already satisfied. So if the file is not on your system, maybe it will do the job for you. Okay, so once after the installation, you can do something in your Jupyter Notebook. One thing I have to mention that Python is such a versatile and dynamic programming language. You can do almost anything using Python. So after the installation, you bring the PyPDF2 like this way, import PyPDF2, and also from the PyPDF2, you also have to bring PDF file reader and PDF file writer, glob, os, and sys. Glob is a interesting package in Python, which also can do some work for you, which is very interesting. I'm gonna show very soon. So once after you type all these packages in the Jupyter Notebook, you have to run them. That means they are already available in your system or in your program. So to run a block of code, once after you type the code, you can either hit a run button or you can do control enter. Okay. So the directory which I gonna working today is, say, the name of the directory is PDF directory. So in that directory, just for showing purpose, I put three PDF file. One is PDF 1, 2, and the one is PDF 3. And IPython notebook is also in the same directory. So once if I want to open the any PDF file, I don't need to mention the path of that PDF file. See what is inside the PDF file 3. If you want to see, there are 10 pages in this file. So this is the PDF file. Okay. So to open a say just for simplicity, I gonna at first open one file, say PDF file 3. I want to open it into the read binary mode. So to open a file, it has to give a name, read file. Then I want to use the function open, then file name, and then just read binary mode. So once I type this code, I have to run this line. So that means this file is available also in this Jupyter node. So in here, there are some sequential instructions. Now in the first one, I mentioned that PDF file reader using that file name. That means if you use PDF file reader, that means that file gonna be read by using Python's one of the packages called PDF file reader, and then available into the variable called this name. So that means this file. Okay, so using this variable, you can get the number of pages from that PDF file. So what you have to do is get number of pages and using that variable and put it into how many pages. So in this case, if you want to print how many pages, then it will give you the number of pages. So print how many pages. So if you want to print that, it will give you how many pages in that PDF file. See, we have shown that there was actually 10 pages over there. So it gonna give you that number of pages over there. As I said before, glob is one of the most important, interesting function where from any directory you can get the name of the file. So in here, I want to get all the PDF extended file into a variable called PDF, and we have to do that using glob. So if you go to that directory, this is my directory. In this directory, there are three PDF file, PDF file 1 or PDF file 2 and PDF file 3. So once after I use these instructions, what will happen is all this file gonna be read by the glob and put it in a variable called PDFs. So once if you type them and you run them, it gonna be executed. And once if you want to print what is inside the PDFs. Let's print what is inside the PDFs. It will give you the name of the file. So this is my ambition. I want to see all the files name into a list so that I can use for a future purpose. Okay, so here is a block of code where I have I will show to get each of the file PDF file name and delete the first page from the each file and put it into a new file. So this is very sort of simple type of code. So to do that, you have to bring PDF file writer and PDF file reader from PyPDF2, and then I use one of the variable called PDFs. In that variable, we have all name of the files. So we use two for loop. Here is a for loop. In this for loop, we bring name of one PDF file. So in the first line, it will print the name of the file, and then we define two other function. One is PDF file writer, which will be write into the output file because we want to delete first page from any PDF file and put it into a new file, and we want to do it into all the pages of that, all the PDF files in that directory. So there are three files in that PDF directory, in that PDF directory. So we want to open all these file and delete first page from each of the file and write down them into a new file. Okay, so and then in this line I define a function PDF file writer, which I will use as a output file, and then in the next line input handler, I mean into the input file, I want to open or read the input file as a write as a read binary mode, and then another function PDF file reader input handler. So this input handle, this file which I already opened as a read binary mode, I read it by the PDF file reader function and put it into a input file name. So as we seen before, that input file name, I mean the any file name of any file dot get number of pages will give you the number of pages of that file, and then in the next line I print how many pages on that file. So once if it is done, I put another for loop. In this for loop, what I did is I say, because each PDF file is started from any Python start, indexing is started from the zero, so I want to only start writing page number one to all the number of pages. So say if the system get the first file, then I want to say do that using this for loop, that from the page number one to last page, put that into a new file called output file. And once you get each pages, so tell me which page it you put over there, and like these two line which will write down the resultant pages into the variable output stream, and then in this line it gonna write down into that file. So finally we have to close both of the files. So once if you run this code, you will see that in the first file, as I discussed before, in the first file there was only two pages altogether. So it removed the first page and then it keep only one page. Second file there are five pages altogether. So the system put all full four pages in a different file and can delete the first page. So once if you go to the directory, you can see that before there was only three files. Now each file is having one new file. Suppose PDF3, before it was 10 pages, at this moment in this file, say we open PDF3, before it was 10 pages, but once after we run our code, in the new file, there will be 9 pages, see 9 pages, and then it removed the first pages. So it started the another pages. So however, this is just an example of how you can do some sort of operation using PDF file. You can may find it useful, and you can do your own practice to do this kind of functions. So if you like this kind of program, please subscribe my channel, and I'll come back soon with some other kinds of materials of Python and all other data science stuff. Until then, Have a good life and goodbye.